Hi there, this video is all about creating something called a baseline grid. Some of you will know what that is, some of you won't. Basically, it's lots of squares like this to add a bit of visual consistency where things start lining up, allowing the design to kind of breathe a little while you're working. Everything has its place, everything's lined up nicely. Let me show you how to make one and why you might use one. All right, so we've done a little bit of this before, but we're gonna go into a little bit more detail now, especially with the grid, okay, and something called a baseline grid system. So let's do the columns first because they're easy and they just kind of recap. So I'm gonna click on my Word homepage. I'm gonna say I want a grid, I want it to be layout, I want it to be, I'm gonna turn it to one, and I wanna make sure that it's my 1366 wide. Okay, so then I know I'm kind of within those gaps. If you do then want to use a 12 column grid, which a lot of designers do, you can type it in there and just use this kind of columns to add a little bit of consistency throughout the web pages. I don't want to add consistency for this particular one. Also, you can do 6, doesn't have to be 12. Okay, it can be 4, just something that's easily divisible. Okay, but I'm just going to use 1. Now we're going to introduce this thing called a baseline grid. So you can have both a layout and a square grid, okay, both of them. And I'll show you what they are. Basically, if I zoom in here, you'll see that at the moment I've got a square grid, okay, and it is a 4-pixel grid, okay, and I think my colors are, the opacity is quite up, quite high. I'm gonna turn it up to really strong so you can see it a little clearer on the video. So basically what I've got now is XD said I'm just gonna give you a guide. Okay, every 4 pixels, I'm gonna draw a little square. And it just allows you, when you're designing, to add some consistency. We're gonna cover this more and more because it's not a hard topic, but it comes more obvious later on when we're working through fonts and a few other things. And you don't have to use a baseline grid, but I'll show you what it does. I'm gonna switch to our old version of the wireframe. Okay, and in here, I'm gonna click on the name and do the same thing, turn on the square grid. And I'm using 8 here. Okay, instead of 4. And what it's gonna allow me to do is, can you see there's no consistency? Can you see this one kind of, see the lines here? They're all just kind of over the place. And I'll show you what I'd end up doing. I'm gonna double click to go inside. And what I wanna do is I wanna try and adjust this so that it'll snap. Okay, so it starts snapping to these grids so that you've got at least some sort of like consistency across these guys. So I'm going to click on them. Drag him out so he's lining up. And you can see now there's a little bit of, it's just one of those things. If you're new to design, when I first started in design, I was like, why would you bother with all the grids? But then after a while, you start realizing there's just a, I don't know, when things start lining up and are kind of consistently left and right lined up, there's a relaxing of the design, kind of like takes a breath and kind of goes, oh, okay, everything kind of lines up, which is nice. But for a long time, I just didn't care, but I do now. Okay, you can see here, I want the spacing is, you know, I want this to be consistent with this. So I'm gonna go into this one and just bring it in, especially if you're not using columns. A grid system's really handy, just to lock it all in, make sure the type's all locked in. You can use your arrow key to type it around. Are you starting to feel me? That's just a quick little introduction of what you use a baseline grid for, and why you'd bother. We're gonna turn it on in this version. We're not gonna have it so dark. And now what size should it be? And we'll look at this later on, but basically divide whatever your body copy size in by half, that's gonna make life a lot easier. So I'm gonna use 16 point and for my body copy. I know that because I use 16 point on everything. If you don't know yet, don't worry, you can change this later on. But I'm using 16 point, so I'm gonna divide it by 2, which is 8 pixel squares. And I'm gonna turn this down so it's not so deafening. Visually deafening. I'm going to introduce a couple of shortcuts. I might have done this before, but it's Command, Shift, and apostrophe will turn on the layout. Okay, so these kind of like giant column. If you do just Command, apostrophe, it turns on the grid. So you end up kind of toggling that on and off quite a bit. So I'm just holding down my Command key, which is Control key on a PC, and just clicking the apostrophe key. I turn this on and off all the time to get things to line up. If you can't get yours to work with that shortcut, it's whatever appears. These are the two that you want on your computer. And you can see in my case, just Command apostrophe. All right, so I've created my columns. I've created my grid system. What I'm gonna do as well before I go is I'm gonna turn it on and I'm gonna set it. I'm gonna make this the default. So whenever I make a new page, it's gonna do this. Same with the layout. I'm going to make this the default so that every new page has this. If you decide to not move on with the grid, I'll understand, it's okay. But for now, let's jump into the next video.
Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up, really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.